This is Todd from Black Spaces. Like and comment for more of our unique critiques. Far too few black women's sci-fi or speculative fiction visions have been properly made into films, such as Janelle Monáe's self-produced Dirty Computer. Octavia Butler, who was a black feminist sci-fi genius, is the brilliant guiding spirit of Afrofuturism. But the FX channel messed up her brilliant speculative fiction novel Kindred by not giving portrayals of her characters that were at least as poignant as the original novel. Filmmakers can redeem themselves some if they do justice to the novels of award-winning Nigerian-American writer Nnedi Okorafor. She works magic on the page with her treasure trove of beautiful African futurism, magic realism, or juju-ism stories. There is the one short adaptation of Okorafor's story, Hello Rain, by C.J. Obasi, about black women fusing Igbo juju magic with technology. Okorafor's best-selling book, Who Fears Death, has been considered for adaptation by HBO since 2017. But in this era of many sci-fi and show developments, why isn't Okorafor's work getting more attention? Most especially her young adult Akata or Incivity anthology stories that are far richer in Nigerian Igbo lore and just as exciting as Harry Potter. This series is a trilogy of books that portrays the coming-of-age story of a Nigerian-American girl, Sonny Onwusu, who is born albino with all of the prejudices albino people face in Nigeria and elsewhere. Sonny unravels a series of mysteries associated with people who have magic powers like her, including her spirit face. She goes on a series of great journeys and missions with her friends, Orlu, the sensible, Chi-Chi, the fun-loving, and Sasha, the hip-hop sassy. She and her friends are guided by elders, including her grandmother, from whom Sonny inherited her magical powers. Anatol, the earthy medium, who connects the travelers to the dimension where other leopard people live. Leopard is the name of these magical people versus lambs or regular folks. Next, Sugar Cream, head librarian of the Obi Magic Library, is Sonny's chief mentor. They teach Sonny how to read the magical language of Incivity symbols, as well as help her mature in the use of juju magic and her jade juju knife as a Nim warrior, like her grandmother. Sonny is connected to the leopard's Knox village and the colorful hidden magical world of others like her. Sonny and her band travel through a series of fantastic worlds or dimensions full of organic technology, but also great antagonists and villains, such as Udide, the great wizard spider that lives under the city of Lagos, as large as a house and emits a smell like burnt tires. Sonny must return a great artifact stolen from Udide by the mother of her friend Chi-Chi. Sonny must confront evil masquerade spirits like Ikwinsu, or the murderer Black Hot Okototo, a serial child murderer. Okorafor's stories are vibrantly steeped in West African, Nigerian, and Igbo religion and folklore, and yet they are full of humor and teenage whimsy that make them highly accessible and endearing. She's a great writer whose imaginative narratives are wonderfully adaptable to big and small screens. Until We Do Right by the genius of black/African women, from the great Octavia Butler to the outstanding Nnedi Okorafor, sci-fi and speculative fiction filmmaking will suffer. For more unique Black Spaces critique, please like, comment, and subscribe.